It's only a setup for your comeback. Just because you're losing in the fight, that does not mean you lost the battle. For the battle is not yours, but it belongs to the Lord. You need to stand up and declare, it's my time to celebrate God. It's my time to reflect on all the things that God has done in my life. It's time for me to celebrate God and recount all of his blessings. When I look back over my life and I think things over, truly, I can say I have a testimony. And my testimony is, when I look back all he's done, how far he's brought me, how he kept me, how he never left me, nor did he forsake me. After I reflect and remember, now it's my time to rejoice. The Apostle Paul said, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say rejoice. In Habakkuk chapter 3, verses 18, it said, yet will I rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. In Psalm 68, verse 3, the Bible says, let the righteous be glad. Let them rejoice before God. Let them exceedingly rejoice. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, when he was at the top of the mountain, he said, rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven. I stopped by this morning. I rose to my feet like a physician in a delivery room to tell somebody this morning, after all the hell you've been through, you ought to tell somebody next to you and say, excuse me, but I'm getting ready to celebrate God. I'm getting ready to celebrate God. What are we celebrating? I'm so glad they asked me. You ought to celebrate God because we in. He woke you up this morning. He started you on your way. He kept you from being seen and unseen. You ought to celebrate God because when fake friends walk away from you, he was still there. When they lied on you, he was still there. When they talked about you, he was still there. Late in the midnight hour, he's still there. When you got more bills than money, he's still there. And because he's still there, that means you're still here. Just somebody say, I'm still here. I should have been dead and gone, but I'm still here. Should have lost my mind, but I'm still here. Should have lost my job, but I'm still here. Somebody, anybody, everybody ought to give God. And I'm still here, honey. I'm still here, giving God the glory. I'm still here, giving God the praise. I'm still here, giving God the honor. And because I'm still here, I'm going to celebrate. I'm going to celebrate because the devil, he thought that he had me. But I got away. The devil tried to take me out. He tried to destroy me. He tried to throw my past in my face. He tried to throw failure in my face. He tried to throw more shame and depression in my face. He made me reflect on who I was and who I used to be. But then I remember who he was and who he used to be. So then I realized that the reason why the devil hates me so much is because I remind him of what he used to do. I remind him of the God he used to serve. I remind him of how good God is. Every time he looks at me, I remind him that God loves me and he saved me. How did he save you, Bishop? It was one Friday. He died. Oh, Calvary. I thought this was a Baptist church. You ought to be excited about the cross. We don't talk about the cross no more. But since I got the microphone, let me tell you what he did. Holy Sunday morning. That he still loves me. He reminded me that no weapon that is formed against me shall prosper. So sometimes you gotta look the devil in the face and say, take your best shot, because the victory's already mine, because God is my judge. Jesus is my lawyer. The Holy Ghost is my witness. And the devil lost the case. And so now I can celebrate, because it's all